Oh my gosh.
It's a sign.
Whoa!
It's a sign.
Join us today. We are honored to be part of their public celebration of their love and commitment to each other. We all have our story of how we know Bridget and Adam. Some of you have known them all their lives, first as individuals, then as a couple. Let me interject here that you may sit down. My personal story begins with Bridget. I met Bridget at the Y while she was working in childcare. I had the opportunity several times to see her in action. She may have been nervous on the inside, but to the kids, she was focused, in control, and very nurturing. Those were two-year-olds whose attention span was even less than mine. I met Adam several years later when he joined Bridget to babysit our new dog, Otis. Though quiet, he was right at home with Bridget and was great to Otis. They met 3 years ago. I don't get the feeling it was love at first sight, but more of a gradual build. Apparently there may have been better first dates, but they kept with it. They took the time to know each other. They found out what they have in common. Things like dinosaurs, being outdoors, certainly teaching, and the love of animals. In fact, perhaps at the reception you'll do your pet voices. Bridget could tell early on that he was a genuine and sincere person and very relaxed. Very relaxed. She says she began to clearly see Adam's qualities when she left Adam at home with her dad, Matt, while they took homecoming pictures of Abby. She was impressed that he stayed and how much he interacted with the family. Adam, on the other hand, thought Bridget was cool and down to earth and very easy to talk to. She was able to engage him in conversation. The two of them, perhaps unknowingly at the time, began to build a relationship. One message at a time, one call at a time, one date at a time. They learned how much they complement each other. Adam being level-headed and willing to clean. Bridget being so selfless and caring of others, especially her family. Bridget makes sure Adam acts his age, while he keeps a level head and life in perspective. Building a relationship doesn't always mean you share the love of everything, nor should it. I'm guessing that Bridget will never love to clean, nor will she always like Adam's music. But they respect each other. They offset each other. They trust each other. They have taken the time to understand each other. They laugh together and not at each other's expense. They find fun in the everyday. They keep each other focused. This is not a relationship that will burn out like a booster rocket and fall away, but one that will continue to build on the foundation they built together. So Adam and Bridget, all I can say is keep doing what you're doing till your last breath. You've had a great role model sitting behind you here. No marriage is perfect, but both sets of parents have worked hard to keep their relationships focused both on each other and their families. You will do well to emulate their efforts. There's no doubt in my mind that the two of you will succeed and thrive together. So, without further ado, let's get this couple married.
Bridget, when we first met, I didn't feel like I had much to offer you. And this caused me to be hesitant to commit to anything serious with you. But you saw something else, and with your love and support, overcame this, and I committed to giving you my full self. This was planned, don't worry. Now when I look at you, I see the future. I see our own house, I see kids, I see family vacations. Every day when I wake up, it's a constant reminder of how happy constant reminder of how happy you make me. You bring a smile to my face simply by coming home, and you always find ways to make me laugh in my worst days. Either you're telling me about Cedric's underground casino, or you're telling me about Finn's traumatic days. You never cease to bring joy to my life. Bridget, I love you. I love you because of your passion and care for others. I love that you're always trying to make the world a better place. I love that you're always trying to put others first, and I love how you always make sure I have my age. I vow, for the rest of my life, to be a rock for you. I vow to always get you water, even though you're closer to the kitchen. I will always be here to laugh and cry with you, and with a love too deep for words, I'm yours forever.
Adam, our first dance song has the lyric, "I didn't have to, but I'm so glad I found you." Well, Adam, I'm here today in front of everyone to say just how glad I am that I found you. I have found someone who cares so deeply for those that he loves. Someone who never gives up on a challenge unless it's a puzzle or a gingerbread house. I have found someone who I want to learn and to grow with. You make my dark days not as dark and my bright days even brighter. I can't promise that our lives will always be perfect or that I won't continue to constantly ask you for water. But I can promise that I will always be your number one supporter. I promise to trust and respect you, to laugh with you during the good times and be a comfort to you to any bad times. I believe in who you are today, who you will be tomorrow, and the couple that we are going to grow to become. Lastly, I promise to love you as my partner, my husband, and my best friend.
The wedding ring seals the vow of marriage and represents a promise of everlasting love. It is a physical manifestation of the promises joining this couple together. The wedding ring is placed on the fourth finger of the left hand, as it was believed that the finger was a direct connection to the heart, the perfect place for a symbol representing love and commitment. These rings are the physical embodiment of the spiritual bond that now binds you together. As you, Adam, place this ring on Bridget's finger, please repeat after me.
You good?
I promise to you, Bridget, before our family and friends, to commit my love to you, to respect your individuality, to be with you through life's changes, and to nurture and strengthen the love between us as long as we both shall live. As you, Bridget, place this ring on Adam's finger, please repeat after me. I promise to you, Adam, before our family and friends, to commit my love to you, to respect your individuality, to be with you through life's changes, and to nurture and strengthen the love between us as long as we both shall live. Bridget and Adam will now take part in a unity tree planting ceremony to symbolize the roots of their relationship and the continued growth of their love as become each other's family today. Bridget and Adam, today you stand before us ready to share the rest of your lives together as a married couple. But long before today, your parents provided you with a foundation of love and caring, which has brought you to this point. Bridget and Adam will both add soil to the planter to symbolize their individual roots and family. This symbolizes the joining of these two great families. It has been through their love and support that has shaped Bridget and Adam into a couple that is committed to a loving marriage of their own. Love is the essence of human experience and emotion. It is the root of all and everything we, as humans, do. Love enriches our experience and fills our lives with meaning. It gives us a firm base from which to grow, learn, and change. I would like to share a reading with you from Captain Corelli's Mandolin by Louis Debonnaire. Love is a temporary madness. It erupts like volcanoes and then subsides. And when it subsides, you have to make a decision. You have to work out whether your roots are so entwined together that it is inconceivable that you should ever part. Because that's what love is. Love is not breathless. It is not excitement. It is not the promulgation of eternal passion. That is just being in love, which any fool can do. Love itself is what's left over when being in love has burned away, and that is both an art and a fortunate accident. Those that truly love have roots that grow toward each other underground. When all the pretty blossoms have fallen from the branches, they find that they are one tree and not two. Bridget and Adam, let your relationship and your love for each other be like this tree you plant today. Let it grow tall and strong. Let it stand tall during the harsh winds and rains and storms and come through unscathed. Like a tree, your marriage must be resilient. It must weather the challenges of daily life and the passage of time. And just like the tree you're planting, marriage requires constant nurturing and nourishment. Bridget, Adam, please add some water to your plant. Remember to nourish each other with words of encouragement, trust, and love. This is needed on a daily basis so you each can grow and reach your fullest potential, just like this tree. You have declared before all of us that you will live together in marriage. You have made lifelong promises to each other through your vows and the exchange of wedding rings. Having pledged yourself to each other, I do now pronounce you married. You may celebrate your marriage with a kiss. At the start of the ceremony, you join me in welcoming Bridget and Adam by their individual names. Now, join me in celebrating them as a married couple. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Zolnaski.